Hey guys, welcome back to Jedi Ride. So today you will be watching the second part of my Kodaikanal trip, and here I'm standing on the ride. We're waiting for my friends to catch up. I'm using my friend's GoPro video. So the restaurant we are waiting at is called Selvi Mess, which is very very famous, and we won't be eating here because the restaurant was closed. We'll be eating over here, which is called Salem Cafe. It is also known as Selvi Cafe. Salem Cafe is veg and Selvi Mess is non-veg. Selvi Mess opens at 10 or 11 a.m. and we were there around 7:55 or 8:15-ish. Don't remember the exact timing, but that was the approximate time that we reached. And that time it was closed, so we just went to Salem Cafe and had some breakfast.
1 hour later.
So guys, I just filled up 9.28 liters and now 9.28 gives me 206 kilometers per liter. So it is 206 divided by 9.28. 22.2 is my average mileage, even though the bike is showing a fairly more. 22.2 is fairly decent mileage, I would say. But I expected this to be more accurate. That's what's more disappointing. What happened, ah? What happened?
I opened the tap, no. Inside full water.
Oh. But how? Did the water mix into the fuel? Huh? Oops. That would have been the second time I broke my display. 36. Thambi, illu 36. Backside. Sorry, yeah.
Where are those boys?
I don't know, they were here all. They didn't stop here.
Why didn't they have gone ahead?
Why do they need petrol? They get such good mileage. Guys, somehow I'm in the mood to belt. But look at the place. People walking everywhere. A lot of traffic, a lot of obstacles. Wait, a red blinking light, what does that mean? Does that mean cautiously proceed? Because in Karnataka, it's the yellow blinking light, which means cautiously proceed. Confusing. When there were free open roads, I chose not to belt due to mileage issues. But now when the roads are like so congested, filled with traffic, and people just swapping lanes, I have this urge to belt. This is very interesting, guys. You see how this, it's jam-packed like a city, but if you just look on the right side, there's a hill, a lot of hills, and if you guys can notice, some of them are merging with the clouds. And guys, honestly, Salem is supposed to be bloody hot and humid. Okay, I don't know about the humidity part, but it's definitely supposed to be hot, but it is not hot. So guys, I just stopped for a couple of minutes because feeling very sleepy, guys. Since I didn't sleep the whole of yesterday, got off the bike and I'm gonna start riding again. I was actually, you know, just walking around here. For about 10 minutes. Because I can't afford to lose my eye. Can't afford to lose any attention on the road. My focus and concentration should be tip top. I did kind of doze off 3 times. And guys, that was really scary for me. Oh, can't corner here. Definitely not. Crazy. Ooh. Is this Kaveri? I guess so.
Actually, I didn't see this guy.
This is Kaveri, no?
Yeah, yeah, I hope so. I'm gonna show my mom, I'm giving her a video call.
Bro, I actually dozed off two times on the bike.
I seated and stopped. Let's take a break.
Yeah, yeah. No, no, I stopped there only. Yeah. I stopped there. I stood for 10 minutes. I walked around.
Bro, I was talking to him on the phone just now when I came. And I stepped down on the fucking bike that comes from here like this, bro. He looks at me in the rear view mirror and says, sorry.
Even I'm going to video call my mom.
Oh shit, there was an
accessory I wanted. My selfie stick. Yeah. It would've been nice.
We're
acting, man. So guys, now we stopped at Vellore Bridge. Not sure what the name of the bridge is, but it's in Vellore and it's a bridge. And now we are going to Dindigul. And after Dindigul, we are going directly to Kodai. So I think there'll just be one final stop, which will be in Dindigul, and then we'll be reaching our destination. And we've done around 279.7 kilometers as of now. Not bad, because the time is just around 10:20, and my average has dropped to 23.9 kilometers per liter because I was belting. What happened was I got really, really drowsy, guys, because I didn't sleep at all. And we stopped at the bridge. I told Rishabh I want to stop for a bit because I feel really drowsy, and he's like, yeah, definitely. So guys, soon the ghat section is going to come up. I think in another 100 kilometers the Dindigul will come. And after Dindigul, we just have the ghat section, which is what I'm looking forward to the most. Very excited for the ghat section, guys. Heavy vehicles keep left, and we have a way. Has anyone ever seen heavy vehicles keep left? Like, just look at this. I see two heavy vehicles and both are keeping right. The only time I've seen heavy vehicles keep left is if they want to overtake a heavy vehicle on the right. we are just 100 kilometers away. 376 kilometers done, 100 to go. So what you see ahead, those hills, that's Kodaikanal, guys. That's what I think. I hope it is. I do not intend to give you false information. But we are really close to our destination, just 100 kilometers away. But this 100 kilometer stretch is going to take us at least 2.5 hours, according to maps. That's fairly true, because it's full ghat section. Like, it's proper curbs, hilly areas. You can't do more than 100. At least I can't do more than 100. What's funny is Rishabh's been asking each and every guy he can for the directions. But I've been telling him, dude, I've been using maps, and he didn't hear that right till now. And just now, when I told him, dude, I have put maps to our lodge. So now, he's still ahead of me. Because he's been here way too many times, he actually remembers the route pretty well. There you go, guys. Kodaikanal, right. Oh, I love how the hills look. It's so sunny right now, guys. It's very sunny. And still, I can see a lot of mist. I still can see the clouds merge into the hills. Right here. So guys, Munnar is just 157 kilometers from here. But the issue is Kerala cops are giving a lot of trouble, like by finding bikes and all of that. Like, one of my subscribers, he texted me on Insta when I asked about Munnar stays. He's like, if you're planning to visit here, please don't come, because so cops apparently asked, the traffic cops asked for an increment in their salary in Kerala, and the government did not want to give them an increment. What they did is they offered them an incentive. And one of the most incredible incentive packages, and I'm pretty sure it's 100% effective. It's definitely a genius. Definitely a genius incentive. What the incentive basically is that a cop, for every 100 rupees he finds, he can make 30 rupees off. So 30% is his commission now to find someone. So now cops are going beyond their ways to go and find people. Like, this is all the information I give you is from one of my subscribers, and he claims that cops have been going to workshops, bike and car workshops, where they put stickers and all those exhaust, those blinking lights, those very like stroke type of the strobe lights and all those very annoying things. And the dad says no race, mom's gift, all those stickers, gel plates, any non-IND plates, then exhausts, fake or original, cops don't care, all those extended mud guards, LEDs, everything, guys. So like, legally we're supposed to keep the bike fully stock. Like, even putting a sticker is still illegal, but cops have really taken this very seriously since the incentive program. So we have decided to cancel Munnar. We are not going to Munnar. We'll just go to Kodaikanal. So guys, now we're preparing the climb. We're preparing for the climb up. This is the final stretch, guys. Just 69 kilometers to the hotel.